Hi, my name is Verbal Dweeb and I'm from Tembisa, 1632. And I'm also known as a rapper, a creative mostly based in visuals. I started rapping in 2014. It began at school. Me and my friends were just there saying, hey, why don't we actually try rapping? And from that point, we went ahead with it and we started writing these little scripts on papers, giving each other the feedback on what we wrote about. Then after a while, that actually transitioned into something professional, I could say, because now we're doing this on a really good tip. And ever since then, yeah, everything has been coming along step by step, from us buying cameras, from us having a studio, to buying equipment. Everything has been slowly gathering up by itself, and all that was through the passion of patience, I guess. We waited, we almost lost hope, some of us, and some actually lost hope. I guess it was not, they didn't have patience. But yeah, some of us are still here and we're still working towards our goal. And yeah, it's been working out nicely. Now, growing up in Tembisa was actually quite an adventure, I could say. By that I mean, if it wasn't for the influence in Tembisa, I don't think I'd be doing what I'd be doing today, because things like you playing on the streets, playing with a brick right on the street, your mom, you know, telling you what time you should go in the house because the streets are dangerous, you know, all of that influences you to have this character that I have right now. So the hood, for me, it was a very good influence, because yeah, I wouldn't be having the shit that I have right now. My friends also, I wouldn't know FKA Moses, I wouldn't know Maxi, you know. Who knows, maybe even Kaira wouldn't be in my circle if it wasn't for Tembisa. But yeah, Tembisa really built me and it created the person that I am today. And I cannot take that back, even if they told me, yo, time travel back and find a place to live, I'd still chill here. I'd do the things that I've been doing 10 years back, 10 times more, you know? Okay, I'm doing music because to me, music became like a personal thing. Like I remember back in high school, I didn't know what I was doing with my life. Like I was asking myself a lot of those questions, like, yo, Ashe, what is it that you want to do with yourself? I looked at school, and school for me, yeah, I was a student, I could say. I balanced in between being good and a bad student, because yeah, I was good at some other things like EGD and yeah, other things. And me transitioning into rap, it was because I didn't see why I should actually prove to people that I should be academic and all fancy with my studies and all. So this is why I chose to do rap, because it was a thing for me that I don't know what to say. Okay. For me, yeah, rap, it was a thing of saying, I'm good with using words, I'm good with talking to people, you know, I'm good with just thinking out of the spot. So rap was for me a thing which was there, it was meant for me, I could say. Not just rap, writing. Yeah. What's unique about my music is that I storytell. And I'm a creative writer. Most of my music is based on feelings. Yeah, I could say it's based on pure, authentic feelings, because I write out of experience. And experience, I feel like with me, experience has been the only thing that makes sense. It's what a musician actually needs in order for them to write music out of realness, I could say. That's where music comes from a feeling. You don't just create music out of logic. Music created out of logic, I could say, it really doesn't hit much, but yeah, it can be created, but it doesn't have enough impact or enough impact towards people and stuff like that. Yeah. Yeah, as an artist, you go through obstacles, and one of them is through performance, of course. And you, as you perform there, and you feel like the crowd is not reacting towards you. Yeah, I felt that too. There was one time at again, this place called Khatalina. No, it was not Khatalina, it was actually Front Page. It was at Front Page. I was there, and literally I saw people leave the stage as me and my niggas were performing, and trust me, that didn't sit well with us. We were just watching, you know. Yeah, I felt like, yeah, we should upgrade. But then again, it was in 2015. Yeah, that didn't sit well with us. That made us wanna like do more and change our style of work and shit like that. Yeah, that was the worst. Okay, some of the mistakes that I've actually encountered in the music industry is not being consistent, not having marketing, not being able to market your songs, yeah, and not being able to have like quality things, like a visual that's quality, your art covers being quality. And how I've encountered problems was through me teaching myself how to work around the field, which is why I did like the graphic designing side of it, the visual side of it, in terms of the videos. Those are the kind of things that you, as an artist, you go through and you find difficulties in approaching, because some people are going to tell you this much money, that much money, and for quality, you know, it's going to be costly. So these little problems are the kind of problems that I had to like remove out of my way, the middleman basically, and become the man who actually does these things by myself. Yeah, I could say it helped me a lot, because it made me find people like Maxi, like a lot of people now, like I'm working with a lot of people in terms of their visuals. Also this whole the wall thing, since we created it, we getting connects with a lot of artists. We actually discovering a lot of potentials also in the hood, which is quite a very good thing, and progress in it also, because that's the more we get exposure to in terms of our work. The five songs that I could say describe me as Bullet for My Valentine, Cry in Vain, which is a rock, metal rock. I really love that song. Eminem, Kim. Yeah, that song is very emotional, and I like how he acts on it. He's emotional, he's showing emotions, even though it's off anger, it's emotion still. And the third song I could say is Tired, which is my song. I created this song out of empathy, out of, you know, I just got out of a relationship, and you know, you get these thoughts and you feel like, you know, I should express what's going through and what I went through. Yeah, that's why the song's title was called Tired, because I was just tired of the whole situation. Yeah, the fourth song I could say it would be Heartbreak. I know all these songs are like based around love, but yeah, that's who I am. I'm an empathic person. Heartbreak is by Yellow Wolf. Ironically, his mixtape, I could say, project is called Love Story, which I titled my EP after his writing his EP also, which is called My Love Story. Yeah, and the fifth song was So Much Better, which is also by Eminem. It's misogynistic, but I love the lyrical content in it, because it describes a man's point of view towards certain female behaviors. It has a lot of misogyny in it, and yeah, a lot of swear words. Yeah, that's the whole song. It describes another personality in me, which is quite fun actually, if you listen to it. Okay, with what's happening lately in terms of like the killing of our women, I feel like with what's happening is because a lot of our male-based society people haven't been taught a lot of things about equality. They still have that old cultural system going on, and most of them, I could say they are not as empathic as they should be in terms of a woman or what a woman is. They feel like a woman is just, they describe women according to how the old times used to, and we've changed actually, because now we're living in a new system. It's kind of difficult for some males to understand the difficulties, or I could say, yeah, the difficulties of a woman, because they expect a woman to dress or look according to how they see a woman. They have a certain perception towards how a woman should be or how a woman should behave, and most of them, they want to blame females, because females are expressing themselves more because the system allows them to express themselves more, which to the male becomes like, oh, what are they doing? Women, they should, you know, which for me is coming from a point of view of saying that kind of man is actually not taught enough about what is really going on. They haven't moved on with the times of what's going on right now. For me, Vabudeep, for this year, okay, yeah, I'll be dropping a few things of mine on before the end of 2019. There's a few content that I'll be dropping on YouTube, not music I could say, but yeah, just content. And most of my music is actually gonna come out next year. By next year, I have like a project, and the project is called Charlie Bonfree, which is going to be a transition from Verbal Deep to Charlie Bonfree. Charlie Bonfree is an alter ego, I could say, of me. The project is gonna consist of 10 songs, which some of them are already there and some of them are still being worked on. And also, I'm also working on a project with Kaida. I'm also working on a project with Brian Supreme. So yeah, by next year you should be expecting a lot from me. Yeah. My name is Verbal Dweeb. I'm from Tembisa. You can follow me on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram at verbaldweeb_SA. You're watching Tembisa Content TV. Peace.